This area of my climb is very, very steep. The elevation is about 300 meters, and it doesn't look like I'll be able to take the beat mat down there. Welcome back, everyone. Today I'm heading into one of my claims to do some exploration work. So stay with me. Okay, so this is as far as I can get by boat. My first boundary marker for my claim is about 100 meters right through that long grass that way. And once we get there, we can start using our beat mat. Okay, finally have all my equipment on. I can get my next bearing and start walking with my beat mat. One of the major problems, obviously, with the beat mat is if you're not on flat ground, the ski tends to flip on you. And then it just rotates and rotates. And of course, it can damage the cable. So you gotta take it pretty slow. There it goes, typical. Okay, we hit our first signal. This big rock right here is giving me a magnetic signal, magnetic 700. It's probably pure magnetite. Pretty hard to see the numbers. So, magnetite can also be significant, so I think I'm gonna chip a piece of this rock and take it as a sample. Okay, so I chipped off a piece of this rock. Doesn't look like much. And it's completely magnetic. So probably just full of magnetite. I don't see any nickel. Nickel is probably the only other thing I could think of that would be magnetic out here. So I don't think it's worth an assay on this. We're more looking for high frequency signals rather than those high frequency signals are conductive signals rather than magnetic signals. I didn't get more than 10 feet away from that mag signal when I started getting high frequency signals. You can hear the machine going crazy. Quite high frequency signal here. And you can see there's this on the side of this huge rock sticking out. This is definitely a spot worth noting on the GPS. And the problem is I should take a sample, but it's hard to get a fair sample because all these rocks have just fallen down, and which one is going to give me the accurate sample that I need. Of course, all these rocks are coming from the source that way, so I should probably start walking up that way with the beat mat, and I think that's what I'm going to do. The signals keep rising as I continue up this hill. So whatever mineralization is here, it's definitely in the side of this hill right here. Just a little bit difficult walking in here, holy God. Can barely walk as it is, let alone drag this ski behind you. Way up here on the high ground, the beep mat is very quiet. Remember, it can only look for signals 3 meters deep. So it's probably too deep for it here. Too much overburden between the beep mat and any possible minerals. Oh, here we go again. Of course, it's upside down. Magnetite again. Big boulder. Looks like just pure magnetite. Wow, look at that. I'll mark the coordinates. I'm not sure how significant that is. This is an interesting tree. It's growing like a corkscrew. And the signals on this side of this dike are quiet compared to the other side. So I'm probably going to sweep back over to the other side and keep looking for samples over there. Small quartz stringers there. Oh yes, something very interesting in there. All that deep purple oxidization. This is probably a good candidate for assay. But again, it was sitting right on the surface. So the source has got to be right here somewhere. I think I better stop here and take some samples. Okay, so the last sample that I saw with all the red, purple oxidization, I said I had to try to find the source. So it had tumbled down this rock, and I climbed up here, cleared off this rock here, and you can see all the little veinlets of quartz. So those minerals were traveling in here. The veins are very small, and my beep mat is not picking up anything. But that could be because it's just beyond 3 meters deep. So definitely I will be very interested in what the assay lab has got to say about the sample here. Another big chunk of magnetite. Yep. Oh boy, that sure is. Too bad I couldn't get rich on magnetite. There seems to be an awful lot of it out here. As I'm walking through pulling the beat mat, obviously I have my eyes on the ground, and I can see all these rocks have been turned over just recently. And it looks like it's a bear, probably looking for ants, grubs, anything they can eat. I'm trying to walk systematically here. But the terrain is so up and down, it's kind of hard to maintain a grid. I don't think I'm going to be able to get to the far corner of my claim today. There's just too much water here. Unless I can find a beaver dam to cross, I'm probably going to have to limit myself to just this half of the claim today. Every once in a while, the beep mat has to recalibrate itself. So it starts beeping at me and says, please initialize. So to initialize, you gotta lift it up in the air, hit the initialize button twice, and wait. Okay. That way it just stays calibrated. It's kind of like ground balancing your metal detector. Okay, and I can see by the GPS, I've been here before, I've completed my circle. Okay, well, maybe it is possible to cross very carefully. That was probably that log. For some reason, logs give off signals. As I was walking by, I thought I could see something spray painted, but it wasn't paint. It's some kind of a fungus growing on this tree, and it's bright orange. I thought for sure it was spray paint. And it's getting pretty late in the year, so we've got blackberries maturing. Still not too ripe. Okay, well, I only have another 150 meters to the corner of this claim, and that's what I want to check. I just want to check the very corner. Certainly the downside of this beep mat is the rotating of the ski. It just keeps flipping over and over all the time. There's a whole bunch of blackberries. The bad thing walking through these blackberry bushes is they're all full of thorns. Just ripping me to pieces out here. There's some more. Oh yeah, that's the stuff. Again, look at all these really bright mushrooms. This area of my claim is very, very steep. The elevation is about 300 meters, and it doesn't look like I'll be able to take the beep mat down there. Well, I'm all finished today, and I got three pretty good samples and some pretty decent signals. I'll have to go back and try to interpret what those signals mean as far as my claim goes, and then I'll send those three samples in for assay, and I'll share the results with you at a later time. Anyway, thanks for watching today. We'll see you next time on Exploring Northern Ontario.